What makes a murder? In the news, one is often shown reports of murders being committed around the world. Many people have a fascination with those who kill, serial killers especially, and often want to know the reason why they committed the crime. This leads to the controversial idea of nature versus nurture. Many scientists argue that the development of killers' brains is different from the general public. However, studies have shown that everyone has the potential to kill biologically. Shows like Mindhunter, Making a Murderer, and many others featured on Netflix focus on the psychology of criminals before, during, and after committing a crime. As science is developing, though, many researchers admit that we know even less now about what causes someone to end the life of another person, and it is getting harder to predict who will commit a crime. Oftentimes on the news, one can see interviews from confused family and friends all describing the murderer as a good person. Most of the time, they complain that there was no indicator that they would commit any terrible crime. Psychologists say that everyone has thought about killing someone else at least once. As humans, we are wired with a flight or fight response, and sometimes with stress and when feeling threatened can lead us to explode. Some people tend to blame mental illness on the results. However, many philosophers from hundreds of years ago claim that humans are naturally born evil or good, and our genes affect who we are as people. They believe that regardless of the background of the person, it is in some people's destiny to do bad things. Looking at the backgrounds of serial killers in the U.S., psychologists generally see a trend of abuse that took place when the person was a young child. This could be one indicator of taught violence. In many cases of prosecuting murderers, they sometimes try to plead not guilty due to insanity, usually based on some story of abuse or external factor. One news article from Fox News claims that there are usually three reasons: financial greed, sexual greed, or greed for control. With these reasons, it could seem that the environment could influence the response of the individual. Oftentimes, children who murder their parents do so because of external factors. A lot of people claim that with the proper family and education, some people would not have committed murder. As always, thanks for listening, you guys, and I will see you in class.